There are a variety of ways to create events in Google Calendar. An event is any block of time you add to your calendar for meetings, appointments, or just time you want to block out for any number of reasons. You may find one event creation method you prefer to use on a regular basis, or you might use them all at different times. It's entirely up to you. One method for creating events is to use the Create Event button in Google Calendar. Clicking Create Event, or using the keyboard shortcut C, takes you directly to the Events Details screen. The Details screen is where you define the basic information for the event, like its title, location, and the event's date and time. You can also add your guests and reserve a room. You can find more detailed information on adding details to your event in a separate video. Clicking Save saves the event and displays it on your calendar. Another method for creating events is using the Quick Add link. You can either click Quick Add or use the keyboard shortcut Q. In the Quick Add field, simply enter some basic information about the event, like a brief title and the date and time. For instance, if you enter appointment with Dr. Rab at Fenton Medical Center Wednesday at 2:30 p.m. and then press Enter or click Add, Google Calendar is smart enough to understand what you entered and creates the event for you. To view the event's details, double-click the darker area at the top of the event. The Quick Add method is a great option when you need to create a personal event that doesn't require inviting guests or reserving rooms. You can also create a simple event by clicking the calendar on the specific date and time of the event. Now you can add a title and create the event, or click Edit Event Details to add more detailed information for the event and invite your guests. When you click on the calendar, a defined segment of time is automatically created for your event. The default time segment depends on your Google Calendar settings. In this example, the default time segment is 25 minutes. If your meeting extends longer than the default time segment defined, simply click the bottom of the event and drag downwards to increase its time. To shorten the event, drag in an upwards direction. Optionally, you can click and drag downward to define the appropriate time segment for your event. Notice that our event has no title. That's easy enough to remedy. Simply click No Title to get to its details screen. You can also get to the details screen of any event simply by clicking its title. The last option for creating an event isn't done through Google Calendar, but through Gmail. In Gmail, click Compose Mail and enter your guests in the To, CC, or BCC fields. Enter a subject for the email and click Invitation. Gmail looks at your guests' calendars and displays them so you can find an available time that works for everyone. Available time is designated by the white space. The pink area indicates that one or more individuals are unavailable at the defined time. After you find a time that works for everyone, change the time, and your guests' calendars automatically refresh. The green area now indicates that all guests are available. Note that if you invite guests outside of your domain, or if a guest isn't sharing their calendar, their calendars won't display. Also note that the subject of your email now becomes the title of your event, which you can change if you desire. With your time set, enter the event's location and optional details and click Insert Invitation. The invitation is added to the email. When you click Send and send the email, your guests will receive an email for the event. Internal guests and any external guests using Gmail can see the event on their Google Calendars. External guests using other calendar applications may need to manually add the event to their calendars. So as you can see, there are a number of ways to create events in Google Calendar. You're not limited to just one option. Try them all and see which works best for you.